Yes, legends, welcome back to Zed Chanarooney. I'm freaking back. I'm not 100% back, but I'm back in the game. I can at least do a video right now. My voice sounds freaking weird. But yo, guys, I've had COVID and it actually fucking smashed me. I actually got absolutely nailed by it. It's probably because I was drinking loads. I was up in freaking my birthday. I went out like, a few nights before that as well. I mean, I did like four nights in a row, and then obviously COVID just saw, had a look at me and said, you know what? He's fucking vulnerable. Let's go and get that guy. It actually hit me. I still can't even smell. And it's been actually a hectic week for me. So, but I'm back. I can do a video. So I'm just going to just dive into this Legendaze. I'm not going to bore you to death with my weird sounding voice. I'm just going to crack on and tell you what I think about Bitcoin and some altcoins as well. Because obviously a lot of stuff happening right now. But guys, I'm going to make it really simple, this video. I already called this dump, guys. We looked at the CME, Chicago Mercantile Exchange. The market was too over the top long. We know that. My previous video, I did state that multiple times. I said that it's put a stop loss in, guys, because don't be surprised if this market wants to come back down and retest some previous support levels to then allow it to springboard higher later. That's what we're getting, guys. And I don't think I'm going to make it really simple, guys. As long as the market is above 50,000, the previous high, we can go below it a little bit. We can go below it a little bit, in my opinion. But as long as Bitcoin stays above $50,000, there is nothing bearish about this on any time frame. Maybe short term, you could say there was a play here. I didn't personally take it. I thought it was going to go down, but I didn't take the trade. I'm not looking to trade short on this yet. But guys, if we're above $50,000, guys, Bitcoin's just, you know, medium term, long term, even short term, my real opinion is this is bullish. This is just the bulls taking the stairs. And this would be the spring down. Anything above 50k, guys, absolutely perfectly fine on Bitcoin. And I do think we are getting towards the near, actually, to the bottom on this as well. If you look at the daily stochastic RSI, this is completely oversold now. We're in the oversold territory on the stochastic RSI. RSI relative strength is almost there as well. You know, having said this, you could get, say that's a low there, here's the next low we got it here. You could say there's nearly trying to get some sort of bearish divergence here, which might push us down a little bit further in terms of momentum. But I'd say, guys, on the medium, on the short to medium term, I believe that we are actually getting to the beginning, potentially the bottom of this as well. You can see, I think, you know, here are the moving averages, guys. We came below them briefly. I think it's going to be very, very similar. Back below them briefly. And then I think that if we hold above $50,000, guys, this will then, we will spring up. We'll break the all-time high and actually our next targets for the upside. I deleted my Fibonacci extensions, but I've got all the levels in. I'm looking at $79,000, first resistance. Then I'm looking at between 100 and 110,000, guys, for Bitcoin. And that's the only levels I really can see above us. If we do lose 50K, though, that will be a slightly different story. And I think actually range lows will play out. Actually, I wouldn't say range lows just yet. I'd say it would have to probably, obviously, be 42K. Between 40 and 42K would be the next level to hit. So if it did something like this and it came down, closed below it, maybe got a rally, resistance, you could see that play out. You know, this could end up turning into some sort of bear market, but we have to lose $30,000, guys, for the bear market to begin. And that would be, in the end of the day, it would give us an idea if we lose $50,000 for potentially coming to see range lows. I think it's unlikely we'll hit a bear market, but at least to hit 42 and then range lows, and then potentially actually play out some sort of like more longer term sideways consolidation for Bitcoin, and then break out probably later next year. But I don't see it yet right now. I think as long as we're at 50K, guys, we're going to go higher. And then when we do get above about 60,000 and 64, so say we come down like this, we get above here, then actually we're looking for some sort of ascending formation, whatever. And then we get above these levels here, then you're actually looking for a break, and then that'll be the breakout for the next move up. Yo, Ethereum. So guys, you know, I said this on the previous stream as well, if we get a bearish deviation from the high price of Ethereum, which is very similar to what Bitcoin just did, this level here, we had the bearish deviation across the high, and I said this would be the box, guys, to look for buying in between two trend lines. You can actually see it from my other charts on Bitcoin as well, that this is actually the region we're looking for as well, and it's very, very similar, guys. You know, Ethereum and Bitcoin trading very similar, but you can see here, guys, from the high price, it is a deviation twice. And then we're getting this level here. It's going to be looked to buy. And guess what? That correlates with, guys, the previous high price between 50,000, a little bit higher than 50K. I'd say between 50 and 53,000 is your level to look to buy. And that actually does coincide nice with the trend line. And then if you look at Ethereum, that actually just basically kind of like lines up quite nice and confluently. I'd say this is the region to buy. You might get something a little bit lower, like a wick through it, some sort of fake out. But I'd say as long as we're above this trend line on Ethereum, it's bull town. We're still in an uptrending market. You can see it's very similar to Bitcoin. It's just retesting the previous high. And then I'd say if we do hold, we're going much higher, guys. And if we do break, then it's just going to be a more longer term sideways consolidation down. You know, I can't see any reason. We're not at the top of the bull market yet, in my opinion. Even if we do break, it'll probably be something like that. You know, come back down, wishy-washy round, and then do it maybe in a few more months. And then, you know, if we can give ourselves more time to accumulate, it's all fine. So it's a win if we go up, it's a win if we go sideways. So look at the CBBI, actually. I don't think the CBBI has actually moved too much recently. I think it's about 60 right now. The CBBI is 59. So you can see here, I don't see any reason why we're not top of the bull market. And I'll go into that another time. Guys, yo, a few things to mention as well. So guys, if you want to trade the market, use Bybit. All the links below, guys, give you a massive bonus. So actually right now on Bybit, you can get a $3,500 bonus. Actually, they actually give you 3% of any deposit. And you can, all the links are in the description, guys, you can see here. You get a $3,500 bonus on Bybit. And guys, if you want to trade altcoins, use Femex. All the links are below, guys. Bybit account. Just what I would just recommend doing, guys, is get a Bybit account, get a Femex account. Then you're literally, you have the guns to fire. You have the you have the weapons in the arsenal, right, to trade these cryptocurrency markets. And if you want to get access, guys, to my personal product, which is called the MDX Trading Portal, where you can get four tailor-made indicators to help you trade the market. They give you a long and short call in the market. Just click on the link which says MDX Trading Portal as well. You can see MDX Trading Portal. So all the links are in the description, guys. Check it out and get all those bonuses, etc. Right, next thing to go through. So we want to look at some of the altcoins, guys. Yo, Ultra, bro. Yo, listen. Let's go, man. I've got enough energy to even to tell you about this altcoin right now. But Ultra is a fucking beast. Like, look at this thing. Still think it's undervalued. It's around a $450 million market cap. Engine coin's like still 2 billion, so I can see that I can still do this thing four times more. You know, it is pretty darn, like, it's pushing for, you know, potentially to have some sort of correction. Like, I'm not going to fucking say to you that just because it's Ultra doesn't mean it's going to have a pullback. It's going to have a pullback. RSI is overbought right now. Stochastic's still okay. Let me go on the weekly on that as well. I don't know if so it's actually overbought on the weekly as well on the RSI. So it is getting, it is overbought, like you would have to say. It's probably going to come back down and retrace to hit the previous high price. Multiple times in history does this. And you can do a very simple technical, you can basically use a Fibonacci. And you can see here that if this is actually the top, the golden retracement is actually coming in at the previous high anyway. And, you know, looking at altcoins, guys, they liked the 786. So I wouldn't be surprised if Ultra did come back and retest its previous high price at some point. And even maybe that trend line there, I wouldn't even be surprised. But for me, it's not any reason to sell because I believe that this company is going to be much, much bigger into the future. And another company, which is growing like a beast, is CRO Legends. I've been talking about this for a long time as well. And again, guys, it is getting overbought right now. RSI is way over. We are literally overbought on the RSI and the stochastic RSI, so on the daily. But when you go down into lower time frames on this, you just have to stick with the bulls on this because, you know, it's moving so rapidly that you don't want to be trying to short into these moves because they can continue being overbought for a long period of time because there's so much great freaking news coming out about CRO as a fundamental company. And that is what is kind of fueling quite a lot of this over-exuberant buying pressure, which will eventually get wrecked. You know, it's not going to go up forever. It's going to pull back to previous support. But, like, you don't want to start trying to short into strength too quickly. So I'll just say that it's above all of its previous highs. It looks like it wants to create some sort of deviation play anyway. This is the trend line to look at. As long as it's trending above the previous high, above this trend line, and it's generally speaking making higher lows and higher highs, and it's above the EMAs, you know, this is just going to continue up higher. So this could potentially turn into an ascending formation like this. It can keep going, guys. I wouldn't try and short yet. If you're looking for a short, wait for a break, wait for a moving average to come down, wait for a break, wait for something to at least give you an idea that this is actually changing trend, okay? So previous high price, you know, all the things we look at in our technical analysis. So CRO, though, is an absolute beast. Like, look at this fucking thing. It's just going for it. But again, it is overbought. So I would say that it's probably nearing the end of its move and it will come back down, retrace as usual, and then you buy the next relevant support. other tokens like Solana. I did actually say I think Solana has hit a top. We are getting that, actually. It actually did break its previous high. It's trying to hold it now. Matic actually looks like one of the better ones to me, I would say. I'm looking to buy Matic at the moment. Ada, I think it has further to go down. XRP, don't really care. Maybe trendline play on this one. EOS just hasn't moved. I'm still long on EOS. Senso, again, this is one of the altcoins I called and actually nailed it. Yo, like, I actually did take a profit on this. And look, Metaverse projects, don't fucking bet against them because, you know, everything's Metaverse right now. I'm like, you know, with Facebook and everything. Shiba. Let's have a quick look. So Shiba, I still think it's going to go lower. It's right on bang on support in terms of Fibonacci retracement 618. It looks to me it's a big descending formation here, and I think it will crack. You know, it could have one more go, but I think, you know, it's a big ascending formation over the previous high, and if it does break it, it's going to go lower. And I just think it shouldn't be a $25 billion market cap coin. So it's over the medium term, it's going to go down. Guys, yo, if you want to talk about freaking equities, like, I think this will come back down. I think S&P will come back down and test this trend line at some point. That probably will coincide with Bitcoin having a pullback as well, maybe deeper. But I'm not looking for... Everyone's talking about this big crash in the stock market. I'm not really calling... you know, it can have a pullback to here, but I don't think it happens this year. I think it will probably probably correlate quite nicely, actually, with when Bitcoin wants to go into a bear market, and that'll be probably midway through next year or the end of next year. I think we're going to go through something like that on the S&P. And then we have a few other altcoins as well. Maybe a little around EOS. No, but BNB. I do hold a bag of BNB. Again, it's just, you know, everything's long until proven otherwise, guys. It's above the moving averages. You just got to go for it. But you Ultra is just on an absolute murk of a job. But I would say it's probably getting a little bit overbought now, anyway. But legends, that's my quick update. I'm knackered. I'm back. I'm going to Dubai as well in a week, so I better be back. And then you're all legends. Comment below as well what altcoin you think is what I've missed this week. Put an altcoin in the description right now, the best altcoin you think I've missed, which is going to pump a Rooney Ente. And then guys, check out all the links below for the exchanges. Get all the big bonuses, $3,500. Get a Bybit account for Bitcoin trading. Get a Femex account for altcoin trading. All the links in the description. You're all legendes. Have a great evening, great day, great night, great wherever you are, motherfuckers. See you later. Cheers. Bye-bye.